Welcome back to Sweet Kitchen Skills, Markus Kriegel here. Today, these beautiful designs and some of the designs are made with not tempered cocoa butter. That means the cocoa butter is not tempered. Let's go. So make a little paper cornet, fill some tempered chocolate inside. This one is dark. And then start to be creative. Start piping some patterns, the pattern you would like, into the cavities. Easiest for me is to just to pipe stripes. I'm not a good painter or drawer. Make sure that the chocolate doesn't set before I scrape it off. So the molds shouldn't be too cold. They shouldn't be too warm either. Typically they are between 18 and 22 degrees when I use them. They need to be perfectly clean and polished. Scrape the chocolate off before it sets. Make it nice and clean. And do some more cavities. I typically make just be three cavities at the time. It depends on how difficult the drawing is. This one is easy, so you can make a lot before scraping. So it's important when you scrape the chocolate off that the edges are nice and clean. Otherwise, you can get in trouble later on. So this one is much easier, just stripes. Scrape off again. That wasn't good enough, so you need to scrape it again. Then let the chocolate crystallize. Let the chocolate crystallize at room temperature if it's between 18 and 20, or put it in the fridge at 14 to 16 degrees. And here, the cocoa butter, you see, temperature 41 degrees, is just melted. And it really, it's not tempered. I put it in my spray gun. Some people told me when you spray cocoa butter, the spraying cools off the cocoa butter and then it's tempered. I don't know if that is true, but I tried anyway. I know that cocoa butter contracts at least 2.5%, and normal chocolate does the same when it's tempered. So I think it's the contraction of the cocoa butter which does the trick. So it's not tempered. I just spray it into the cavities. I make sure I hit every angle. I make sure it's really green. This one is apple green from Pavoni, a really, really nice color. Thin layer, but covered. Then clean off the edges, of course. Always wear clean. Let it crystallize. And now I make exactly the same with tempered cocoa butter, just to see if we can see a difference. And by now you should know, tempered cocoa butter is 45 degrees warm, you cool it to 26, and then you can use it right away at that point. You can also heat it a little bit up to 27, 28, 29 degrees, but I just use it at this temperature, so it's about 26 degrees. Put it in my spray gun, spray the cavities, and then I crystallize the cocoa butter before I fill tempered chocolate inside. Keep a little distance when you spray the cavities. My spray gun is I try also to get very close just to see the difference, but normally I spray from a distance. I use a water. It's spray gun, 0.5 millimeter, but definitely I will in the future I will buy another spray gun, and it will be 0.8 to 1 millimeter. It gives me a lot more color, you know, a lot more color comes out of the gun. So spray, don't make the layers too thick, thin layers. And now I use white cocoa butter. This one is 44 degree. It just went off. So, but it is 44 degree warm. So I use not tempered cocoa butter for the not tempered cavities, and I use tempered white cocoa butter for the ones which are tempered. So the green is crystallized, put the white on, make sure it's everywhere, clean it, let it crystallize. Yeah, let them all crystallize. That means 10 minutes in the fridge, they're ready. And then I make some tempered cocoa butter. Again, 45 degree, cool it down to 26, and I use it at that temperature. I use the white cocoa butter because I'm going to put black or dark chocolate inside the cavities. If you use white chocolate, you don't need to paint white before. Yeah, clean the molds, nice. Let the cocoa butter crystallize for about 10 minutes at 16 degrees. Then fill with dark tempered chocolate. Mine is a normal dark chocolate from Calabout 811. Has about 38% fat. Sometimes I put even more cocoa butter inside to make it even more liquid. Right up to the edge, remove air bubbles by hitting the outside of the molds. Turn the molds upside down and scrape, make nice shells. So, I told you to put the cocoa butter inside the fridge overnight before I put chocolate shells in, and then put the chocolate inside and when you make the shells, and leave them again overnight. Today I make everything different. I do these shells very fast. It took me 2.5 hours to do them. So that means crystallize the cocoa butter, put the chocolate inside, leave them for 2 hours in the fridge, and then I take the shells out. So, not tempered cocoa butter and made very fast. You have to decide what you think. I think they are really beautiful. I could have put a little bit more green color, but I think they are really, really nice. Nice and shiny. I will keep an eye on them the next couple of months. See if the cocoa butter stays like this. If I get fat bloom, I will see. These are the ones with the tempered cocoa butter. You see, it's much more green because there's a lot more color. This design is, to me, even more beautiful. Nice and shiny. But you know, it's hard to see a difference. Both designs are very beautiful. I will try to do tests with not tempered cocoa butter. And next time you will see those ones. Smileys. Difficult to do. Takes a lot of work. Some of them, they're hand drawn. These ones, all smileys, are very beautiful. So I will show you next time how to do them. They are very popular. So I hope you'll be back. See you soon. Bye bye.